टुडे वॉज आर डे 3 इन कश्मीर एंड टुडे वी विल बी गोइंग टू अ प्लेस कॉल्ड पहलगाम एंड यू सॉ दैट आई हैव माई सूटकेस राइट ओवर हियर बिकॉज वी आर गोइंग टू हैव अ वन नाइट स्टे ओवर देयर सो लेट्स जस्ट से गुड बाय टू आर हाउस फॉर नाउ एंड आई थिंक यू डिडंट सी माई प्रीवियस वीडियो अबाउट डे 1 एंड डे 2 द लिंक इज इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन डाउन बिलो यू कैन चेक दैट आउट एंड आई ऑल्सो आई वॉन्ट टू थैंक माई dad's friends family for letting us stay at their house so yeah this is day 3 so like a regular drive mostly takes around 3 hours or 2.5 hours but this time it took us a little more because we had a few more stops in between so right here when we were about to turn onto the highway there was this whole formation kind of thingy that was going through which had more than 42 cars vehicles and you know there were a lot of them and these were all military vehicles and they were I think going to a base We stopped and then even more of them came and like they were just coming and coming and coming. I just shot this. So like just watch this and now there will be no sound. The next sound of mine will be after this clip. So after the formation cleared up, we actually stopped on a restaurant which was in Apple Valley and then we crossed the river Lidder and then we reached our room. So this is like a room tour. This is the entrance. This is my suitcase and everything. This is the bed and all the towels are kept over here. And this is like a cupboard which has an extra blanket and a pillow inside just in case. And here we have a table with a kettle and here we have a TV. Very nice. We have some sofas right over here and this is the bathroom. All nice. The sink. It has 2 bars of soap and it is all sanitized. Very nice. Nice shower and everything. And yeah, this is the room tour and just a little more left. This is the heater, you know, you can use in winter and this is the best view of the river Lidder. So after we freshened up, we got down into the park which belonged to the property of our hotel. So I'm actually going to leave the hotel's name in the description down below. You can go ahead and check. It's a nice one. So again, this area's name is Pehelgam and it is also in the mountains for some reason. I don't know why we are going in the mountains again and again. But yeah, then we just went a little, you know, just to take a round of the area. And these sheep are blocking the way. Then we went on this really dangerous rocking wooden bridge and this bridge I think I want to call the death bridge because it was really dangerous and just see how dangerous the flow of this river is and like it was really shaky I was scared so I didn't even go halfway and then just came back So as I said before, the bridge was really shaky, but it was, you know, you can see these cracks in between and everything. So I was pretty scared. So I just, that's my brother. He's just removing his shoes and like taking a dip in the water. Not just going inside, just, you know, putting his feet and everything. And yeah. Oh, that's my brother. I don't know why he looks so cringy in that, I don't know how can I describe this. Okay, this is also cringe. Okay, so now we went on this bridge which was way better than the previous one because it was not that shaky. It was really well protected. And then we went for some snacks and I had a nice grilled sandwich. Then after that, I just went back. Went back to the room and then just fell asleep like a baby. Today was day 4 and here I am going for breakfast. We locked our room and then we just head down. So yeah, this is me going downstairs, eating breakfast in our hotel. And then after eating breakfast, we checked out and then we went to a tourist spot. I think there wasn't much left. That's why we are going back early. And yeah, we went to this trout farm. Trout is actually a fish that can be only found in cold waters, which are only in Kashmir and Denmark in the whole world. And then we set off after seeing the trout farm. So then we also went through a toll in between, but I guess nobody was there, so we just, you know, went. And then we stopped at my dad's another friend's house where they served us some Kashmir stuff, and then he explained us how this saffron farm works. So he's like explaining, so like this is like a seed and you only have to sow it only once. So after that, when you harvest all the saffron, you don't actually have to replant it again, because the seed till around 50 or 60 years or something. And last time somebody sowed a seed was around when his grandfather was around. And so water also is mostly like poison to this these seeds. So that's why they have created this design, so that all this water comes and it just slides and it doesn't like damage everything. So he also told that it was not like a plain ground before. This area is actually specially reserved for saffron growing, and so nobody can actually build a house over there. This is the rule by the government. And then we set off till home, and that was the end. Now it's time for the important announcement. So I went to this video right over here and checked the comments, and there were almost 12 comments. And look at all these comments over here. The oldest mod, bro. This one looks like just, it's normal, you know, it's like very normal. But then there were more of them. Like, this guy is like spamming all of these hate words and everything everywhere. He's saying, I wish you didn't upload videos and everything. So I reported a few of those and they like disappeared over there. He actually didn't hear that properly. You call that a traffic jam? Just two cars. I don't know why he is like so mean. Do you even know how to play Minecraft? Like, this is like really hatred right now. I don't think so. I should be opening comments right now. And yeah, I'm now going to soon report all of these comments. So you guys have time, I think, till Sunday to just go and check it out. And the video's link will be in the description down below. So go and check out that hate comment. And you can also you can also help me out by also reporting his comments. Thank you very much. Bye. And also, the reason I'm sounding really dead right now is because I'm really tired.